Good morning, guys. This morning I'm going to show you how to put a name on your stockings. These are from Dollar Tree. And we're going to be using our Cricut machine. I've got a Cricut maker. And I've already got my vinyl on here that I want, my iron-on vinyl. I'm sorry, and I've got this, I just measured it, so let me turn it over. When you're doing iron-on, you always turn it over and put your dull side up. Just like that on your mat. And if you've got a brayer, and I do somewhere, and it's right away. Okay, hang on just a second. Here it is. Thought it took off running, but it didn't. Here it is. You've got one of these. Go ahead and use it. It does help to get your vinyl adhered to your mat really good. And we're also going to be using the Cricut Mini today. This is brand new. I just got this. So I've got her ready to go. Excuse me. And I'm just going to show you guys how to iron this onto your stockings or whatever you want to put them on. So, alrighty. I've got to have two hands to put this in my machine. So I'm actually going to cut you off again and let you wait a minute while I go put this in the machine and let it cut. And I'll be back in just a minute, but before I go too, I want to tell you, anytime you're doing iron-on, let me turn my tablet around here. Can you guys see my tablet? Yeah. Anytime you're doing iron-on, right here it says Mira, you're going to cut that on, and it's going to turn all your names backwards. So remember, always cut your Mira on when you're doing iron-on. It doesn't matter what type of iron-on, you know, everyday iron-on or whatever. This is glitter. Always turn your mirror on, because your fabric, or your vinyl, I call it fabric, your vinyl is turned upside down, so this is your backing, and you want your name to come out on the pretty shiny side. Alrighty, I'm gonna go get this in the Cricut and get our names cut and come back and we'll weed it and get it put on. I'm back for just a second. I forgot to show you something. I always forget to do this. And hang on one second. My machine is not on, I don't think. No, it's not on. So once I get my machine on, it'll show up in the select accessory here. Right there, maker. We're waiting on this to continue. Now we're going to select our material. And I'm going to use glitter iron-on. It says make sure your mirror is turned on. And you have to load this blade in clamp B, which is your fine point blade. And I'm also, right here, my pressure says default. I'm going to go ahead and put it to more. Okay. And I'm going to get this in and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. I got the names all finished. And of course, you see some of the vinyl's gone. I had to recut one of the names. It ran off my mat. This mat is not a, it says Cricut, but it was bought from overseas. So, grid is not the same as a Cricut grid, and I wasn't thinking about it when I done it. I was running it on the 10 inch line just like the thing says on here, and like I said, I wasn't thinking. This mat's totally different, and it did not go over just far enough to catch the B on one of the names, so I can see the B on my mat here where it's got it. So anyway, I ended up cutting that name over. But I was going to show you, when you take your vinyl off your mat, the best thing to do is turn your mat over like this and start bending your mat backwards and holding your vinyl down with your hand. What that does is it keeps your vinyl from bending and messing up your letters or whatever you just cut out. It helps keep your vinyl straight. You're just bending your mat and it doesn't hurt your mat to bend it. So it's just better to bend your mat than bend your vinyl, because you don't want cracks and wrinkles and stuff in what you just cut. Okay, now what we're gonna do is we're gonna weed these. And what I try to do here on this, I'm gonna go ahead and cut this name down, so the least amount of vinyl you have to deal with, it's gonna be easier to weed. So I'm just cutting off my excess vinyl here. There we go. Now, I'm gonna come over here and we're just gonna, I always just take and put my weeder right here in the corner of my vinyl, because where I know there's no letter or anything, and it just bends back my, it bends back the vinyl right here like that, enough for me to catch it. Or you can leave your this in here and put your finger here and just pull. But I like to let go of it and actually pull it with my fingers so I can pull it easier a little bit at a time. And make sure you guys, yeah, you're watching me. Make sure I've got you in my camera there. And you just come back slow. Iron-on usually, the glitter iron-on usually weeds really easy. But you just want to be careful, because you don't want to tear something you don't want tore. Now, and see, when you turn it over, there's your pretty side, and that was your dull side there. So when you turn your name over, you have your name's going to be pretty. So now it's got to weed out these centers out of the letters here. Now that we've got all that, we're going to turn it over and make sure we've got everything out that we need out. And you're going to end up with that. So, ain't that pretty? Okay, now what you do, and I've already pre-pressed this, just to make sure it was laying the way I wanted it to lay when I put his name on it. And of course, this lines are not straight, so we can't go by the lines when we put it on, so we'll just have to make sure we're straight here. But you want to go ahead and warm up the area that you're going to be putting the name on. And ideally, I should use my bigger easy press so it can cover the letters all at one time. But I wanted to try my little mini out and see how it done. Since these are just names, we'll be okay. So I want to come on here and I want to put this, I think I want to put his name down right here. And like I said, you gotta be careful because those lines will throw you off. So I'm gonna lay it down on there and then I'm gonna hold it up and see if that's gonna look good. And make sure everything looks straight. I think I need to come up on my B a little bit. Tell you what we could do, we could put his name right up here, and I think I'll do that. It may look better. Oops, I'm losing stuff behind me. Oh, my little Cricut easy press box fell off. So I've got to be careful here too, because we got all this fur up here. So I'm going to put his name right here. I want to go on the dark line, because that way the name would show it better. Now, I think I'm going to like that better and put it up there. And my puppies are going wild this morning. Okay. Now, it says to hold three. Trying to remember what it told me on that. The easy press. Okay, 330 degrees Fahrenheit. 330 degrees Fahrenheit for 30 seconds. Well, this doesn't have a temperature setting on it. So I went with a high setting. So we probably don't need to hold it long. I'm just going to come on here and go just for so many here and then so many on the other half. This for just good measures, I'm going to hit it one more time. Just want to make sure it's kind of on there. Like I said, it's the first time I've used my mini. So you guys are getting to watch me use the mini a little bit. And I'm going to let this cool down for a few seconds. We're just going to peel it up slowly, very slow. You don't want to pull anything off. And there we go. Bojangles is on there. Make sure you guys can see that. I'm using my phone today, guys, so I apologize if I'm missing something here. I think I got y'all in there. And what we're going to do one more time is we're going to turn this over. We know the name's right in here. And this is felt, so we want to be quick. I don't want to melt my felt. So this just catches it from the back side. So that's... You have to be careful with this felt, so... There's something inside here. Oh, it's stuck to the front of this. Where the... Oh, heck. Come on, Hunter. Oh, okay. Because this is such thin fabric, we're going to have to put something in between here. Because the glue on the... The glue from the vinyl... It comes through. Okay, so now we know that we're going to have to put something inside here. It didn't hurt anything. Everything's fine. Didn't hurt a thing. Everything looks just fine. So, there's that one. And we're going to do another one while we're on here if you want to watch. And I'll do it right and put something inside. There's a piece of cardboard in here. And I'm going to leave it. But I am going to try to press this. Because these things aren't folded. I guess the way they laid them, they just kind of ended up rolling the way they wanted to roll. So I'm just going to hit this with the press. Right here. Okay, now we're going to weed this one. This is the big one. So we just have to be careful and do it slow. Let me put you up here on top of this so I know you can see it. So we're just going to run down and we're going to pull it slowly, like I said, because we don't want to tear anything we don't want to tear. Okay, so let's watch every letter. See, that one tore, but it didn't tear where I needed. I mean, didn't tear a letter. Now this one's gonna be harder because it's going through that E there, so I'm gonna pick it up easy with my fingers. So you just have to be careful and watch what you're doing. You can even take your pick and grab up inside letters there, so it'll help come off real easy. There we go. The E's seem to be the harder ones to get up inside, and the S's. Okay, so let's finish this up here. Let's see, you didn't want to pull off, so just like I said, just take your time. Get all your little center pieces over here. Or little extra pieces. So this stuff usually weeds really well. I'm just trying to take my time with it and make sure, like I said, I don't tear anything I need. Okay, now we'll just go back and take out what we don't need out of the centers and your little excess pieces here that fell out here. This is the one that I messed up on here, part of the B. So I'm just gonna cut it off here. I might cut these off individual anyway, so. Lay it over here to the side. And there's those names. I'm just gonna go ahead and cut them into. I got one more piece right here. I see I need to weed out. And the shorter, the taller you can go. Okay, we're gonna get this back on. Okay. Got him all weeded. If you can see him or not. And we're gonna put him on here. On the, I'm just putting him on one that I don't have a name on, because I do have two puppies that didn't have names. So I want to give them something. And I've already pressed this, trying to get it to lay right. It's just got that cardboard in it. It's going to keep it from laying right. So I'm going to go ahead and get this heated up right here where I'm going to put him. Make sure. And if I'm going to have a name on him, I'm going to put it right up here. So I want to make sure this is down. Right there. I'll hold it up and make sure I like it. Yep.
If you can't afford to pay off all your debt, do not let the credit card companies trick you into thinking that you have to. Call Credit Associates now for free information on how to get debt-free faster than you ever thought possible. Without bankruptcy or debt consolidation.
Looky there. Isn't that adorable? That looks good. Okay, guys, I'm not going to make you watch me put them on every one of them, but I wanted to start it out with one without a name. And just wanted the guys, wanted you to see that you could put names, or you can put images on as well. Alrighty, guys, thanks for watching.